How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to the ASMR play of Yu-Gi-Oh! The Falsebound Kingdom. When we last left off, I almost fell asleep. We've got Yugi. We ended up getting Mako Tsunami. Changed his team around a little bit. I probably should have bought more Beast Fangs. That's my B. But I put the Enchanted Mermaid, Octobursar, and Fiend Kraken on him. I was trying to debate if I wanted Fiend Kraken or Karyushin. The reason I went with the Fiend Kraken is because he can blind opponents eventually. And I mean, I would have used Jellyfish, but... So the Jellyfish can actually inflict critical damage with every hit on machine-type monsters after a certain level. And then Karyushin can actually hit all three for its special. But Octobursar and Enchanting Mermaid at a certain level, which I'm not sure yet, can both do the same thing. They can hit all three, the entire team. So I thought it'd be a good idea to have at least these two and then have someone who can potentially blind opponents. And of course we got Bakura, we got the standard setup. One thing I want to show you all is this item right here, Multiply. I will be getting two more of those on this mission. You specifically get them on this mission. And we're going to be getting them. So I'm going to save. And here we go. The Beastie Badlands. The nighttime music is just the most relaxing music in my opinion. Look at this place. Welcome to the Beastie Badlands. Not even the Empire has sought to control this area. However, if we can secure a route through here, it will allow us to hit the Imperial forces in their weak spot. We must be extremely careful. There are roving bandits and monsters that will attack anyone that tries to pass. Furthermore, we cannot expect to find much in the way of supplies. We must not prolong our stay here. Keep an eye on the clock and be ready for anything. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to get Yugi, and we are going to be fighting a very powerful monster. I actually don't think it's a good idea to send Yugi. Oh boy. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and send Yugi. This is probably a terrible idea. I might have to restart this. But we're going to send Yugi. And I'm going to have Tristan head over there for backup. Bakura, I'm going to send over here. And this outpost right here, specifically, Tower Sirius, is where you get the Multiply item. Now, there are two sets, there's one set of roaming monsters and one monster. Here at the Tower Pegasi, there is a roaming, or there's a monster that lives there. And oh boy, he does not play around. He is your first level 99 encounter. You must like living on the edge to violate this hallowed ground. Let's see if you have the power to back up such foolish behavior. Attack when you're ready. The Summon Skull, one of Yugi's most iconic monsters. Right behind the Dark Magician, I would say. Yeah, level 99, he does not play. So, he has Knight Adept, he's Aerial and level 2 magic, and he has the ability to attack Dark Lightning, which inflicts heavy damage on machine monsters. Oh boy. Now, he has the potential to knock out Karibo in, like, one hit. But... that's all. We're gonna see how well this goes. This could be a failed video, and I might have to end up re-recording. Because I do want to get every single monster. Oh, we're doing well, but I'm afraid of when he finally hits. Oh, it's gonna hurt. And here it comes. Oh, he's going for Silver Fang. That's weird. Look at that. 500 damage straight off the bat without items. Wow. He doesn't play. But with all the equips we have, we should be able to beat him pretty easily. Yeah. So I guess this was kind of oversold to you guys. But if you don't have, if you're not using equips, oh, I remember the first time I played this game. He beat me. Summon Skull beat me, and I was using Yugi for everything, so I lost. And I had to redo this map. This is the first time in several millennia that I have ever lost. Your power makes you worthy to command me. I hereby swear before all that is dark and bestial to serve you as your faithful servant. And we got the Summon Skull. Alright, real quick, let me get a healer. And the not the trade union. Barricade. I'm gonna throw that heal on Silverfang, and we actually don't need Tristan over here, but we'll have him here as backup just in case. Yugi should be able to take everybody out. And now you all get to see the first special attack of this playthrough from Karibo. It is Multiply. You can only use this after getting that specific item for Karibo, which I had got when I was doing a little bit of grinding. So we just press Z. And there we go. Karibo too strong. Look at that. 400 on everybody. Yeah. Karibo is... Who would ever thought that you would hear someone say Karibo is a very powerful monster? Karibo is one of the best monsters in this game. I'm not joking. Which, this game is one of the reasons why Karibo is one of my favorite cards. Karibo is in my... like, top 10 favorite cards. I actually prefer the winged... Oh, wow, that was a crit. Good job, Celtic Guardian. Oh, the silver bone. No? Wow, that was just a random crit. Good job, Celtic Guardian. But, my favorite Yu-Gi-Oh cards, I would say, are... My absolute favorite card is the Dark Magician Girl. Number 2 is Sagi the Dark Clown. Number 3 would be the Magician of Black Chaos. Number 4 would be Dark Magician. Number 5 would be Dark Magician number 2. Actually, I think I do like Wing Karibo a bit more than the Dark Magician. So yeah, I think Wing Karibo is actually in my top 5. And Karibo was in top 10. Took that one. Alrighty. Yugi should be able to beat them pretty easily. Now, this might seem a little weird, but a Summon Skull I am not actually going to put on Yugi's team. I know that sounds crazy, but, and I will be taking Karibo off of Yugi's team. Yeah, Yugi's team is going to get a little bit weaker after this, after we're done here. But we do actually, I believe we do get a third monster here, and it is a very iconic monster. So, currently, we got... On this map, you can get a total of 4 monsters. Man, Karibo is just powerful when he has that item. Because the special thing about the Multiply item is that regular items only give you a boost of 500 attack. Multiply gives Karibo a boost of 1,000. So with those 3 items, you're basically giving, basically Karibo is eating a Blue Eyes White Dragon and gaining its power, like he's Kirby. Just from those 3 items alone. And now I'll be having Yugi take on the other roaming monsters. There are three more roaming monsters. And there, it's one team. It is... I'm trying to remember. Wow. There's the Neck Hunter. The Illusionary Gentleman. And... I know the monster. I know the monster, but I can't think of its name. Gilfer? I think it's Gilfer. Beast King Gilfer or something like that. I can't remember. Because I'm saying Gilfer, but I'm also thinking of Gilfried the Iron Knight, which is a card that Joey uses in the anime. He used that during Battle City. You guarded. It's not going to matter. Kuribo too strong. Look at that. Kuribo broke your guard. Apparently Kuribo not strong enough. Thank you, Kuribo. I recently learned there is an actual Yu-Gi-Oh card called Wolf. Literally just Wolf. It's kind of weird. I don't know if it's a... Actually, I'm not too sure if it is a real card. I'm pretty sure it's a real card, though. Because it is in the game Yu-Gi-Oh! The Duelist of the Roses. Which is a game I would really want to play for you all, but I can't get the PS2 stuff working. PS2 is a little bit harder to get working for some reason, but everything else... Crazy. Good job, Yugi. Gonna heal you up. Tristan, you can go ahead and head in here. And Bakura. We're gonna set up a trader. And this is where you can get... Oh, you can also get the Cocoon of Evolution. Make sure you buy one of these. Because you can use that to transform your Larva Moth into the perfectly ultimate Great Moth. You can get Larva Moth in Kaiba's playthrough. Getting two more multiplies. Okay, now Yugi. It's about here where he can fight that monster. I might just have Yugi take everybody out. No. Oh, here we go. And just where do you think you're going? How dare you try to pass me without so much as a greeting? Such impolite behavior must not go unpunished. Attack, minions. Attack. I mean, those aren't exactly minions, but, you know. Minions are little purple, or purple. Wow. Well, technically there are purple minions. But yeah, he's a lot easier to beat. Beast of Gilfer. Oh, I was mostly right. Oh, he's Knight Adept. Now, all three of them are Knight Adept, but I am going to be putting Neck Hunter on Bakura, just because it just goes really well for Bakura. My very first playthrough of this game, I lost to him as well. Kuribo, you missed. You get some pretty decent monsters. Now, roaming monsters normally don't have items either. So, well, he guarded. I want to break that guard real quick. I specifically wanted to break that. That way Kuribo can attack with his special. Gilfer is a monster that I really do like. I don't have the card for him, but I wouldn't mind having it. It's a card that Yugi used, which is really weird because I did buy way back in the day the Legendary Collection Gold for Yugi, which had... Ooh, that was a crit. Which had three of Yugi's decks, and the Beast of Gilfer and Silverfang were not in it. Okay. Good job, Yugi. You're awfully strong. I think I'll give up. I hereby submit myself to your care. I pledge my loyalty to you. I'll do anything you ask of me. The Illusionary Gentleman, Beast of Gilfer, and Neck Hunter. Well, if he'll do anything I want, I would like him to wash my car. Karibo, you're going to go ahead and head back here. And I want you, Makosu, not me. I want you to go and battle them. This is actually a place where Simon isn't too useful at, just because the items I have on Simon are specifically for making him stronger. Now, you have to have Yugi be the one to beat this mission. Yeah, it must be Yugi. Tower Denib. You'll end up coming back to this map eventually, and you'll want to head to this place when we do, Tower Denib, because you can find the Time Wizard here, but that's not going to be for a good 5 or 10 missions? I'm not too sure. Mako, I really hope you make it before Yugi, but you're not going to. Yugi, I'm just going to throw you right there. Alright, Yugi boy. So Mako, you're going to... Does anybody have any beast fangs? I really shouldn't be wasting the money, but... Dragon Trasher, Puppet Tag, Polly... I think this just has the basic healing items. Yeah, I should have known. They usually only ever have the basic healing items. Okay, Mako, you're almost there. I do want to get some experience on Mako. Oh, blue and red medicine. Now, of course. Nope. And he waited. I'm hoping we can get another attack off. Oh, come on. You're full of crap, game. Okay, take one of them out. There we go. We're definitely gonna have to fight again. Attack the putty cat. And you guarded. I'm waiting. I don't like waiting, but sometimes if you have to, you should just do it. I would definitely recommend anybody trying this game out if you want to. Again, it's a very good game, Mike. You guard it again. We're just gonna go for the snake. Alright, Sedusa. Okie dokie. You'll be fine. You don't need a heal. Take out this last officer, then Yugi can do the rest for us. And he waited. Panther Warrior's a nice card. I really do like a lot of the older Yu-Gi-Oh cards. It's crazy how they're worth so much more, too. I mean, when I was little, I remember going to the store, seeing, like, you know, the starter decks, and it's like, oh, you know, $10 for a starter deck. And nowadays, you know, those starter decks are $400, $500, $600. And, like, the Legend of Blue Eyes stuff, man. My uncle had a bunch of those old-school Blue Eyes. You dare violate this hallowed ground. Just who do you think you are? I'm going to stop you in your tracks. Hello, Pain. Or Darkness Ruler. His name was Pain in the anime, if I'm correct. You hear that, everybody? Naruto stole this guy's name. Everybody can heal. Oh, man. You know what? We're just gonna see what we can do. I don't think we're gonna be able to take him out. Yeah. Oh, no, we did. Okay. I was not expecting that. Well, no monster was born for you, buddy. Yeah, you can heal. Good for you. If you want this guy's monsters, you've got to play through this a lot. We're gonna do a special again. We'll attack the King of Yami Makai. Okie dokie. And the Poochie will eat this guy. Or not. He's gonna heal. Aw, he has a red medicine. That's gross. I bet you think you're cute. You can't stand against the power of the Karibo. Wow, 500 from the Karibo. I'm telling you, Karibo was doing the same amount of damage as Summon Skull, if not more. The issue is Karibo has very low health. Okie dokie. I really hope the music isn't too loud. I probably should have turned it down more, but I wasn't too sure. Air Shrine was liberated. He said, Agua. I'm sorry, Master Scott. And you, Yugi, I've been waiting for you. That's right, we get the Dark Magician. Specifically, the green one. Waiting for me. Yes, ever since you stepped into this world, I knew it was you right away. As Master of the Dark Magician, I swore eternal loyalty to you. Don't you remember? No, but though our forms may change, the bond which binds us endures. I am, and always will be, a faithful servant. I fight for your victory, and for your glory. The Dark Magician. One of Yugi's best cards. It's his ace monster. Crucial battle. Yugi's daring plan turned the tide of the battle. They attacked from behind and set the enemy running. Resistance-controlled areas quickly spread as Yugi and friends repeatedly defeated the dazed Imperial forces. Seeing the entire Imperial army in disarray, Yugi decides to surround the largest fortress in the Empire, Ino. With the capital of Sigvarth's just beyond Ino, if Yugi takes the fortress, he'll have the Empire by the jugular. How many kids are gonna know what a jugular is? With his entire empire at stake, Emperor Heishi himself leads an army to face Yugi and protect Ino Fortress. The fate of the Empire lies in the balance as their greatest battle yet is posed to start. Okie dokie. First things first, Karibo, make you even stronger. 4,400. That's a pretty powerful Karibo. Ooh, we got the lucky ability. Oops. Okay, let's go back to Karibo, which is our most powerful monster at the moment. Karibo is our most powerful monster. Luckier than most, it's very good at dodging enemy attacks. Yeah, Karibo is our most powerful monster. Man. I think I'm actually gonna keep Karibo on here. Silverfang is actually our weakest, but yeah, normally I don't do this, but I'll take off Silverfang and keep Karibo here for now. I don't normally do that, but okay, I'm gonna, here it is, Book of Secret Arts, and now Dark Magician is stronger than Blue Eyes White Dragon. Unfortunately, we don't have a healer on our team anymore. That's the only issue. The Dark Magician will end up getting some good levels. I might grind, I'm not too sure, but yeah, I think I'll go ahead and keep Karibo on here. Now, you... I want those items off of you, dude. What? There you are. Those are not for you. Okay. I did kind of want to use him, but I'll be putting the Nick Hunter on here. Night Attack. Well, Korra's team is just a weird, you know, gaggle of goofballs. Team is going to be changing a bit. Not that wasteland, not okay. I was really wanting to keep the drag. I was using him, but oops. Give me the items back. Okay, buttons. Getting rid of you, and we are going to be putting on the Illusionary Gentleman. Wrong one. The Summoned Skull, who is also Knight Adept. Put on two Black Pendants and one Violet Crystal. Man, I really want to keep this one on here, but I have a specific team that I use for him. I think that's fine, actually. Mainly just because, like, this monster can eventually poison. But, I mean, Illusionary Gentleman. It's what I normally do. And he is Knight Adept. Book of Secret Arts. And the Violet Crystal. We'll keep this goofy looking dude though. We got two fiends and that yellow is gross looking. Okay. I did keep Beast of Kilfer though. Maybe it's time to get rid of this little dude. Let me check the items. The Sword of Dragons. Okay, I'm actually gonna leave those on him, and I'll throw you on here. Yeah, you don't have too much synergy with this specific team, but I don't know. Black Pendant, and we'll throw Red Medicine on you. That's not too bad. I do like that purple. been trying to get. Maneater bug, I don't think we need anymore. I got you strong enough for now. What I was gonna do. So, I'll do. Well, I guess we got that silver thing on her. Yeah, that wouldn't be bad. That way we can still use silver thing. No need in throwing away Yugi's Poochie. And this thing's orb is just so pretty. Like, it's such a disgusting monster, but it's such a pretty orb. I think we're good. Okay. Then. That's it for this part. So, I will catch you guys later. See you in the next part of Yu-Gi-Oh! The Falsebound Kingdom, the ASMR play.